extremely hard to find in the used RV market. This is a Jayco Seneca Super C diesel big boy right here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. This is the 37FS, which is a bunk model, although it could very easily function as a couple's coach and just use that area for storage. One owner, we originally sold it right here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. Basically, the folks went around, had a good time, built some memories, and decided that they're done with the mobile living lifestyle. So you have a chance to take home a hard to find high dollar item at tens of thousands of dollars less than brand new. Well, especially with things like that full body Sikkens paint job that you have on here, it still looks fantastic. Now this is a very involved, high level product. We're going to kind of go through this thing in several waves today. I'm gonna kind of mention some generalities and then we're going to do some specifics. And at the end of the tour, we're actually going to take a little bit of a test drive together, so buckle up. And one of the things I like seeing in here is that it was kept clean. And I, you know, it seems like it should just go without saying, but I can't tell you the number of times I find a really high level coach like this and someone thinks that they've arrived in life. Well, maybe, but you still got to take care of your stuff. And these folks definitely did. Now there's a lot of good things going on. Like we got like a 34,000 BTU furnace. There's dual 15,000 BTU air units, both with heat pumps, by the way. And you can see how our main deck here, no floor vents, easy cleaning. All of our woodwork in here has just got a very upscale kind of rich look to it. Windows all open up, 7-foot interior. And just like Diesel Pusher, we've got a soft touch noise canceling ceiling liner up here. We're going to kind of look at this thing in multiple waves. I'm going to be a little bit more generic, a little surface level right now. We are going to also go on a test drive later. I've recruited my buddy Adventure Aaron to do some driving. And while we're doing that, that's when I'll bust into a little bit more detailed technical specs. Now, quick note on all these windows is that they're all dual pane windows. That's a standard thing on the Senecas. The stuff that other coaches tend to dream of having, Senecas have standard. Like up here, you can see we've got our automatic leveling system. And this would also be where you'd find your controls for things like the electrical system, inverter system, so that if you you can run any appliance in this thing pretty much any time, on-grid, off-grid, whatever. Now up front here, you have the front, wow, that is just a wicked glare coming in through that front windshield there. There is a privacy curtain that you can put up. I probably should have done that, but regardless, up here, instead of just a, come on camera, plain overhead cab, you've got a full like overhead entertainment center, and you can see how that just really adds a lot of extra storage. But what's cool is it does still have a bonus sleeping area. And like all Jayco's, any like over cab sleeping area has a best in class 750 pound weight rating. So it's a single bonus bed when you want it, or guys, you could just take the mattress out and congratulations, it's a mega drawer, effectively, kind of cool. Now over here you can see you've got the single recliner and that can turn and pivot and whatnot, but it is cool, it gives you the extra seat, but it's fixed in place so you don't accidentally rock and roll it and fall down that staircase, because that is a bad thing to have happen. Now one of the things that we will talk more about when we go on our test drive is everything up here in the cab, but these are like air ride seats like you'd find basically in a semi-truck. This is a Freightliner business class chassis right here. And those are like air cushion seats. So if you are going to be on the road a lot, this is just one of the smoothest feeling things because you have another layer of cushion basically before the shocks and jolts of road transit are absorbed into your body. Now, interestingly and very uncommonly, that sofa we're looking at is a conventional like inner spring style classic hide-a-bed. You don't find that used much in any segment of the RV industry, especially the motorized industry. Now, one thing they have here, Jayco, they call it their patented Dream Dinette system. I call it a no-knee knocker because you don't have the posts or anything in the way. But that is an easy up-down sleep system. There are seat belts all over that dinette, by the way. They're just kind of tucked under the cushions right now. Solid surface countertops, not just in the kitchen, but also over there on that table. Now, there's already a lot of prep space here and that's all a real tile backsplash, but that you might notice below the closest portion of the countertop there, there's an extension. There's an extending peninsula you can use for extra prep space when you reach your destination. And I've never heard anyone ever say there's too much storage, there's too much counter space in my RV, and I doubt I ever will. Not at least someone saying it seriously. Now, cracking open all the storage there, you can see there's a bunch of stuff in this thing still. The people that owned it, they're just done RVing. This was all stuff they had dedicated to just keep packed in the RV, so they don't really need it anymore. So they said, well, if somebody wants it, it's theirs. If they don't want it, I guess they can throw it away. So really kind of a no harm, no foul sort of thing. By the way, this is, of course, convection microwave. And you might have noticed, if you're paying attention, that is an induction cooktop. What's cool about that is, this being a bunk model, logically, you probably have kiddos, or you're planning to have kids in it at some point. Well, if you're done cooking, like seconds after you take something off an induction cooktop, the heat is gone. And I love that accent light inlay in the side of the countertop. Now, this is that extended peninsula storage I was telling you about, and it's got drawers all the way through it. So it's not just a countertop that sticks out. It's a full cabinet that comes out to you. It's pretty cool, actually. I like how they do that there. Instead of an oven that most people don't tend to use in motorhomes or in RVs in general. I know there's some folks, but most people don't. Big drawers right there, and a four-door gas electric fridge freezer right here. Kind of ends the kitchen before we cross that wall into the bathroom and sleeping cabin areas through the sliding privacy door right there. What's really cool on these bunks, they're super traveling and rainy day friendly with the handy drop-down entertainment system right here. So if you're going to be on a long trip, everyone needs their own little brand of entertainment to keep themselves occupied. You've got it. This has a basically built-in DVD player that can pop down when you want it. And there are a couple little plugs you might be able to expand your entertainment to a limited degree. Now, down here below, they're on both bunks, by the way. Those entertainment systems, I don't want to just gloss over that. It's cool that both bunks get them. But under the lower bunk, there is this handy extra large drawer right there, which, again, there's never such a thing as too much space. Now, the bathroom door here, it does lock. So if you are in here, if you're in the shower, you do maintain full privacy. You don't have to worry about somebody walking in on you. And with this being a 7 foot tall interior, you should never have headroom or, with that radius shower, elbow room issues. A neat thing in this bathroom is also that one piece seamless molded countertop and sink combo. There's no seams where water can slip in there and cause any issues. I feel like that is a upgraded replacement toilet, like it sits a little higher, but I could actually be mistaken on that. Now, a neat thing here in this bathroom is that thing with the red glowing light on it right there. This has a tankless water heater system, so what that kind of means in English is unlimited hot showers for the family, and the larger vent fan up here to help get all that humidity out after you're done bathing, always a welcome thing. Now, from the angle that I was standing earlier, the bunks look rather small. The good news is they actually do kind of sneak around in there. Each bunk has, we've already seen the entertainment center, but its own shades, its own breeze window, and its own curtain. So everyone has their own comfort. And then little things, it's not a major deal, but that little light, that running light right there, lets you see just well enough at night to be able to navigate your way from any of the sleeping quarters to the bathroom. Now, here's a big cool thing. This is a king bed, which is still hard to find in the Class C market, but at the time this was built, virtually no Class C coaches had king beds. And that was one of the main things that Seneca said, look, you know, not only do we have the bigger tow capacities versus a conventional Class C, but we also have those great big sleeping quarters that, you know, a lot of people just can't find anywhere else. Tons of storage space in this slide as well. You've got six big dresser drawers down there. I see all the original owner's manuals and everything present and accounted for. The sliding mirrored wardrobe doors here hide a big closet. Definitely plenty enough for the whole family. But even the TV gets on the act. There's even storage under that screen right there. Now, one of the other things here is it's not just storage across from the bed, but you've also got some pretty big storage going on above the bed here. And with the inclusion of some shelves in these very large overhead cabinets, you see, you can really pack that thing full. And all that's well and good. But how about this? How about the fact that the previous owners actually installed a full washer dryer set? So if you want to do some living on the road, if you want to do extended trips, if you want to do the snowbird sunbird thing and you're like, I am no way ever using a public laundry service, congratulations. You don't have to. We're gonna begin on the exterior with some things that are a little more obvious, then we'll start to get into things that are a little less obvious. And I can't cover every single nut, bolt, widget, and whiz bang on this RV naturally on a quick flyby tour like this, but we're gonna try to give you a pretty good idea of what you're looking at and answer the bulk of the more common questions. For anything more specific, contact our team. We'll get into it for you. So, kind of like, again, a Class A, we've got a full outside entertainment center, and it's completely separate from everything that's going on indoors. So you can't have true dual zone entertainment, or I suppose with the TVs in the bunks, like five zone entertainment. Triple power entry step gets us in and out of that coach very easily, and you can see even up to that Freightliner cab, we've got double steps for easy sort of come and go in that area. I mentioned when the video began, all these Senecas are a forced standard full body paint job with a variety of paint called Sikkens paint, which it sounds really fancy dancy that I know the name brand of the paint that they're using, but frankly that's the exact same paint that 99% of the entire motorized or even towable RV industry uses when there is a full body paint package involved. The good news is it looks good. It doesn't look scuffed up. It doesn't look like they bumped into anything. It doesn't look like some low hanging tree branches have scuffed or scratched or anything on them. Everything in here looks good. Slide awning looks good. Roof looks good. It's got this, it's basically got like a diesel plus your roof. It's a full one-piece fiberglass roof that's actually hoisted in place and not built piece by piece. This coach has that tankless on-demand hot water system. So especially with this being a bunk model, you could have a lot of bodies in there. The good news is you can all take hot showers and not have to worry about taking cold showers because somebody ate up all the hot water. Long as you have 12 volt to run the circuit board and long as you have propane to power the burner, you got hot water, ladies and gentlemen. Now, one of the main appeals of a Seneca, a Super C, a diesel C like this, compared to a conventional Class C, is its tow capacity. It has vastly higher tow ratings than a conventional Class C, like 10,000 pounds and over, effectively. So there are some people who like, they like to haul classic cars or race trailers and things like that, things that have a serious amount of weight with them. This is the kind of coach that can accommodate that sort of use. So let's crack open some baggage compartments and then we'll crawl up onto the roof. Even the baggage doors of this are unlike a conventional Class C, which usually has more travel trailer style baggage doors. This has more of a diesel pusher, swing open, slam latch baggage door with a gas strut to keep it held open because it is actually a little bit windy out today. It is nice that these things are not flying around. You'll find that these compartments are all ABS compartments. And oh, by the way, I should have mentioned this sooner. The tires look fantastic. There's no issue with the tires here whatsoever. But these are ABS compartments, so if there's something a little bit wet in there, no big deal. Now this one actually passes over the drivetrain, so if you do have something like long, big folding picnic tables or chairs, you do have a good spot for things like that. And a twin set of compartments over here on either side of those triple power steps kind of finishes off. But once again, this one has a little bit of extra space up there. Back on the opposite corner, I'm a little close to that darn bush. When I arrived to, you know, take our footage today, I found it parked next to this, which seemed fine until you open all the baggage doors. This has an 8,000 watt diesel generator here, and this is a quiet generator. It's right under your master bed, so you do want to make sure that that's not going to be rumbling too loud and keep you up. Right next to that, all of our docking stuff, basically water, cable docking. And what I'm seeing here is that everything seems to have been really well kept. It's all got a place. It doesn't look like anything was sort of used, abused, tossed in haphazardly. And again, just like you saw inside, you're going to find a couple random odds and ends, things people have. But this right here is awesome. It has a 50 amp cord reel. And you can see that there are surge protectors and the centipede slinkies for your sewer system, all sorts of things. Things that I don't care if you're a first time or last time owner, these are things that you're going to want you have. That's a power cord reel, by the way. That's a tricky thing to say. It's a power cord reel. It's a 12 volt extend and retract system. So that if you don't feel like physically manhandling and lugging around a 50 amp cable, you don't have to. All the batteries seem good to go. I was obviously running the lights inside. I can't find anything that mechanically scares me out here. I mentioned it at ground level, but hey, why not? Let's get up here and take a look at this thing. You can see the diesel pusher style roof that we're looking at. It's also really cool. It throws people off initially. You see where the full body paint stops when you hit the roof line.
That's completely by intention, because you're going to still want to go through and do all your washing and checking your seals and whatnot, but the fact that this is white will keep the whole coach far, far cooler in the hot summertime, because it's already going to generate enough heat. Thankfully, the dual air conditioners and these air conditioner, attic vents will help keep that excess heat from boiling you to death. Now, obviously, you can see up here, we have a traditional antenna system, but a big WineGuard direct TV system was also added onto here and all wired in. So if you are looking for that, you know, good TV anywhere, as long as you're subscribed to that service, you're going to be good to go. Now, other than that, there's not a whole lot else up here that we can really take a look at. So I'm going to hand it off to my buddy Adventure Aaron, and we are actually going to take a loop on the Haylet Circuit.
All right, I'm Aaron.
I'm Josh.
And we're going on a road trip.
Going on a road trip, guys. See, this is the extra effort that we go to here at Haylet RV of Coldwater, Michigan. Giving that extra information that, you know, you just don't... I've never seen anyone else do something like this. One of the big differences I've always maintained on a motorhome is that in a motorhome, your vacation starts the moment you shift into gear. You're on a road trip, buddy.
Woo!
Party. But in a towable RV situation, it's a lot different, because your vacation starts after you get hooked up, after you pack, after you get there, get unhooked, leveled, slides open, awning out. Right now, we could turn on some music, we could have a good time, we could chit-chat, I could navigate back through the cabin, and we could have ourselves a good time. Now, there's a lot of really cool features on this RV that are very difficult even now to still demonstrate. Well, one of the things that Jayco really prides themselves on is creating, in their own words, the best handling, quietest riding RV, period. That's their goal. And the way that they do that here on the Seneca series, it's called J-Ride Premium. And there's a lot of things going on, so pardon me if I have some cheater notes, but I want to make sure I get this right, because this is not the least expensive purchase you could make in your lifetime. And you know, I want you to have good information. That's sort of why we're doing this whole adventure. J-Ride Premium is actually, technically it's 5 components in one package. I personally have always felt that it's 6, and I'll explain that. The first is that this is on an all-air ride suspension, so it is just like the US-12 that we're rolling down right now. How smooth is this every day?
It's nice. Yeah, this is...
It's a lot better
like
than...
riding in a cloud.
It's a lot better than your little VW and my Kia.
A little bit.
Yeah. My little Korean Mini Cooper, right? Kia Soul. The other thing is, it doesn't just have rear stabilization bars, but it actually has front anti-sway bars. And the reason that's really important is what they've kind of found is that your... I think your blinker's on still, partner. We're taking the Haylet loop. Fantastic.
About to do a hot lap on the Haylet oval.
Yep. So what you're kind of seeing here is also pretty neat in that as soon as you turn your signals on, your rear view camera or GPS unit all-in-one also flips to the associated side view right there, and there it clips off right when you need it. But what I was getting at, it also has front stabilization bars. Because what they found is that sway in transit, it starts up front. We're passing Haylet RV right now, actually. So by controlling sway in the front, by preventing it from doing this in the nose, you prevent it from doing this in the tail, so it all comes together. They also have 60 millimeter Bilstein shocks in the front up here. And if you're not familiar with those, it's a different kind of design. Long story short, a conventional sort of tube-in-a-tube style shock absorber, it gets cavitation, it gets air bubbles built into it up over time. So when you first start driving, like when we just started right now, you wouldn't notice a lot of difference. But like if you're going to take this big sucker, you're going to go to Florida, you would notice the front end starts to lean into those corners a little bit more. You're starting to feel that bump when you hit the things in the front. The Bilstein shocks will be 99% consistent the entire time. They don't have that cavitation effect, long story short. What this all means in English?
I'm gonna make it a lot easier for you. They're German.
I suppose, yeah. It kind of like that ShamWow commercial. Yeah. He's like, yeah, it's German. Everything good comes from Germany, right? Of course, didn't that guy get arrested for whatever? Anyway.
Their engineers are pretty good.
The part of the ride and handling here is that both Aaron and I are sitting on air ride seats, which actually surprised him. This is on a Freightliner business class chassis, and you sit down and it goes, whoosh, and like the little bumps, like I can hear like a cabinet jiggling here and there a little bit inside.
It's pretty quiet.
Yeah, it's quiet. We don't feel any of that up here, though. Are you feeling any of it in the steering wheel or anything?
No, and when we make this left up here, this road is pretty bumpy. This is the one that really will test out
that shock,
how well this
shock
rides.
Absorber land. Yeah. But one of the other things that goes along with what I call J-Ride Premium is the sixth portion, and that is the dual pane windows. So I've talked about there's a difference between dual panes and thermal panes. Where these things will be nice, what dual pane windows do very well is they knock down a lot of extra noise. And when you're going down the road, there's a ton of wind buffeting noise. There's other vehicles. And then when you reach your destination, there's people chattering around, walking outside, dogs barking. So the dual pane windows do wonders to keeping the volume down in here. Now, there's a couple things that we haven't seen while the RV was parked. Specifically, we're in travel right now. We want to see how it handles, you know, or how it looks in travel mode.
All right, so flipping ourselves around here, you can see this is what it's going to look like from the co-pilot seat. One of the cool things about a motorhome is you are free to get up and navigate the cabin. Now, ideally, what you're supposed to do is get up, get what you need, and then get back to one of the seats that has a seatbelt, whether it's the dinette, the front area, whatever. Now, it is kind of nice if the driver says, hey, I'm about to hit the brakes real hard, so the idiot doing the video doesn't get tossed around inside of it. Let me shed some light on the situation. Hit that little accent light button here. So here's a nice little pass through the whole thing. You need to get to the fridge, you need to get to the bathroom, you need to get to the all of your sleeping areas. You can navigate all that right here, and when we're not whipping around a corner, I will continue. Individual little privacy curtains here, so even if you're zipping down the road, people aren't looking at you as you go back. Now, one quick note, you can still access this king bed here. Obviously, you're not going to walk around it when the slide retracts. The slide here, the closet, does go over the foot of the bed a little bit, so you are going to lose out on a little bit of that. But overall, now, this would make less noise if I actually had closed the door properly last time, so that makes a difference. But we are going down the bumpy road, as Aaron called it. Not too bad. Pretty quiet. Like, you don't hear a lot of banging and jiggling. That's actually one of the things that these induction cooktops are good for, because it doesn't have a lid to jiggle bang around. It actually is pretty darn quiet in here, you know? Now, I can hear that we're going down the road, but it's not any louder or any more aggressive than when we were, like, if I was in a car. I think that's pretty much the same, don't you think?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, Josh adjusts himself right there. I mean, it handles really nice. It's smooth. Definitely the air ride is fantastic. Easy to keep in the lane. Great visibility with the larger mirrors on both sides, as well as having the rear view as well as side view cameras really assists in making turns and anything else you're trying to maneuver something this large around.
Oh, we're coming up here to a pretty sharp S-turn that you're going to know how it handles basically pretty well. Now, a couple things for you guys, some real, tech information, basically, because there's going to be some people that really want to know the technical side of this. This has an 8,000-watt quiet diesel generator, 1,800-watt pure sine inverter, so if you want to be able to run household outlets pretty much anywhere, you can. As I mentioned, we're on a Freightliner Business Class M2 chassis. It's a 28,000-pound GVW, 33,000-pound GCW. If you don't know what those numbers mean, give our team a call. We're on a Cummins 6.7 liter 340 horsepower diesel power plant. That'll get you up and down the mountains. You want to go cross country touring, or where this one's really nice is it has a 10,000 pound tow rating. So like a conventional Class C has a 5,000 pound tow rating, and that's enough for like a little car. But there are some people that are like, hey, I go to antique tractor shows, or I want to haul something a little bit more than just a car or something like that. This has that extra tow capacity, very much like a big Class A. Like I said, it's like a Class A that just forgot to actually become a Class A at the last minute. It's just like, oh, that's a Class C. That's supposed to be an A? Oh, okay. You know, it's a very uncommon but specific criteria here. Silver Bullet Coors Light truck. Follow that guy.
Let's go.
Right now, everyone's like, seriously? You drink that cheap Coors Light beer? Yeah, I do. Now, you don't see it. What? Now, I do. I totally do. You can't see it because I do my best to hide it. Plus, nature's getting rid of a lot of my hair. But back here, I grow a natural, curly, wavy mullet and Alabama neck conditioner. And the moment that that hair, if it grows down and hits my shoulders, it's Billy Ray Cyrus country all over again. I grow a scraggly neck beard. I just try to keep it trimmed up and churched up over here. I've got serious redneck DNA in me. And I can try to hide it all I want. At the end of the day, there's something about a Coors Light.
Silver bullet.
Well, this traffic stop brought to you by Haylett Auto and RV Supercenters. Yeah. Dealing, discounting, and saving since 1989. 30-year anniversary, Haylett RV Supercenter.
Absolutely.
That should be
a commercial.
Actually, we should just pull down to the radio station and record that.
Record that right now.
Boss would be like, what's this $300 radio bill? I'd be like, funny thing.
About that.
About that. We were following the Silver Bullet truck, and he'd be like, say no more. So we've been at higher speeds, we've been at lower speeds, we've been on bumpy road, we've been on smooth road. Got it, handled that corner good, didn't it?
Alright, full disclosure, this is my first time ever driving a Super C. I've driven a diesel pusher, classy, trucks, all kinds of stuff. First time ever driving a Super C, and it's incredibly easy. It is not hard at all.
You know what I'm liking about it? This is something, I got leg room.
Yeah.
This is nice. And this seat can slide back. Actually, these are multi-way power adjustment seats. And again, they're both air ride, air cushion. I mean, you know, it's taking a lot of the shock absorbing right out of this thing here.
Yeah, a long road trip in this would be super easy.
So on the left, you can see our primary Haylett RV lot. That's where we've got about 450 different RVs sitting at any given point. We've never tried something like this. If you like what we're doing here, give us a call at Haylett RV. Give us a chance to work with you. That's all we ask. And short of that, as always, take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.
Have a good afternoon. We're calling this one Seymour, by the way.
Seymour. Why Seymour?
Well, it's a big rig, so there's a lot to see, number one. Number two, something like this is really going to allow you to see more of the United States. And it rhymes with Seneca. So, see more of the Seneca.
How does it rhyme with Seneca?
They both start with S.
That's not rhyming, that's alliteration.
Yeah, whatever.
We'll
I didn't realize this was an English class.
Well, I didn't realize you didn't know our English language. There's not much to say.
I got nothing.
We'll put that on the highlight reel.
Yeah.
Road trip! Ow!
Party's over.
All right, kill it.